howdy partners. Probably won't say that all day here, but it is Go West, and it's music with Michelle and time for another live stream. Here it is August 18th, 2022. I'm just making sure I'm not uncovering some of the background that you'll see on the other camera angle. There's some more parts to it. Here we go. But I hope you're all staying well and looking forward to doing some singing. Right away, I will, I guess, remind or mention that this live stream is not country music. That is a whole large category of music. Although I'm sure some of these songs could be considered country tunes, I wanted to focus specifically on songs of the cowboy and cowgirl. And there's some really old ones and some newer ones. So let's get right in it, shall we? Let's hit the trail. Okay, folks, so we're out on the trail. And of course, I'm originally from the prairies, but maybe not the 1800s prairies, maybe not. So for those of you that are, anyhow, this is a song that we probably all learned in, maybe in school or in like brownies and scouts and stuff. It's an old tune, not written by, but recorded by Gene Autry. That's a famous name. So what I have to start off to sing with you guys is Home on the Range. And the instrument I'm going to play on my keyboard is this one. Of course, it's a harmonica. And that's the easiest instrument to pack in your pocket when you're anywhere, especially on the trail. So let's get on our horses and sing together Home on the Range. Give me a home where the buffalo roam, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the skies are not cloudy all day. Seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the skies are not cloudy all day. How often at night, when the heavens are bright with the light from the glittering star, have I stood there amazed and asked as I gaze if their glory exceeds that of ours? Home, home on the range, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the skies are not cloudy all day. Oh, give me a land where the bright diamond sand falls leisurely down the clear stream, where the graceful white swan goes gliding along like a maid in a heavenly dream. Here we go. Home, home on the range, where the deer and the antelope lay, where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the skies are not cloudy all day. Where the air is so pure and the zephyrs so free and the breeze is so balmy and light, that I would not exchange my home on the range for all of the the cities so bright. Home, home on the range, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word. And the skies are not cloudy all day. Right, well, hopefully you were able to sing along with a lot of that. There's more verses than I ever realized when I did learn this song. There you go, and my own harmonica playing. That kind of harmonica is a little easier than the real one, but I recommend you get a real one if you want to go out in the range. There is a little bit of information on cowboys that you probably don't know. I think a lot of people get their cowboy information from movies. The golden era of cowboys actually did have a beginning. It sort of feels like it's always been there, but it was the golden age anyhow. It was said to have started around 1866. After the Civil War, the Union Army had exhausted its supply of beef. It was $4 for a steer in Texas. But $40, now that's a lot of money in 1866. So they needed people to get the cows from Texas to the north, and that includes Canada. I think it's really interesting to note that they figure perhaps a quarter, 25%-ish, of all cowboys were freed ex-slaves. So it's maybe not accurately portrayed in a lot of things that there would have been that many black people who would have been cowboys. Cowboys weren't necessarily gunslingers. They were just really hard workers. They could move 3,000 head of cattle about 15 miles a day. They couldn't go more than that because then the cows would be too skinny when they got to the north. So that's kind of something to think about. And of course, I don't have the full outfit, but I have the cowboy hat earrings. They're really cute. But cowboys didn't change their clothes very much. They had to wear the chaps, which is the leather across the legs, of course, to protect them from the thorny branches that the horses and everything would go through. And the hat to keep out the sun. But not only to keep out the sun, but the hat, you could scoop water for you to drink and for your horse and the cows. Now, talking about cowboys singing songs, cowboys are famous for singing songs. And that is partly to while away the time over your beans and chicory coffee, whatever, at the campfire. And partly because at night, the cattle would get restless. There could be thunder and lightning. Anything could spook them, and then you'd have a stampede. So they would sing. They would sing to the cows. Oh, little cow, you are so pretty. No. That is not what they would do. And a lot of the cowboy songs are like work songs on a ship, interestingly, where one person would sing in one part, somebody would sing another part, and they would toss it back and forth. So that's what we're kind of imagining while we're out here on the trail. An old cowboy went riding out one dark and windy day. On a ridge he rested as he went along his way. When all at once a mighty herd of red-eyed cows he saw, bounding through the ragged skies and up a cloudy draw. Their brands were still on fire and their hooves were made of steel. Their horns were black and shiny and their hot breath he could feel. A bolt of fear went through him as he thundered through the sky, for he saw the riders coming hard, and he heard their mournful cry. Yippee-yi-yay! Yippee-yi-yo! Ghost Rider. faces gaunt, their eyes are blurred, their shirts all soaked with sweat. They're riding hard to catch that herd, but they ain't caught 'em yet. 'Cause they've got to ride forever on that range up in the sky. When horses snort and fire, as they ride on, hear their cry. Yippee-yi-yay! Done by him, he heard one call his name. If you want to save your soul from hell, riding on a range, then cowboy, change your ways today, or with us you will ride, trying to catch the devil's herd across these endless skies. Yippee-yi-yay! Much for joining me on a hot, hot day here in BC. Just put out the usual tip jar notice there if anybody's interested in throwing a couple of dollars towards an old cowgirl like myself. I much appreciate it. This next song is another old traditional cowboy song. Here it says it was performed under the title that I call it, which is Get Along Little Dogies. Now, dogies are not dogs, even though the words are so similar. I wonder if you know what a dogie is. I tell you what, I will tell you. Dogies aren't just cows. They are, and I quote, the runty or orphaned calves. That's not my word, runty, but there it is. As I was a-walking one morning for pleasure, I spied a cowpuncher riding alone. His hat was thrown back and his spurs were jingling, and as he approached he was singing this song. Whoopee-tie-i-o, get along little doggies, it's your misfortune and none of my own. Whoopee-tie-i-o, get along little doggies, you know that Wyoming will be your new home. Early in the springtime we round up the doggies, mark them and brand them and bob off their tails. Round up the horses, load up the check wagon, and throw the little doggies out on the north trail. Whoopee-tie-i-o, get along little doggies, it's your misfortune and none of my own. Whoopee-tie-i-o, get along little doggies, you know that Wyoming will be your new home. Some boys goes up on the trail just for pleasure, but that's where they get it most awfully wrong. For you haven't an idea the trouble they give us while we go driving them all along. Whoopee-tie-i-o, get along little doggies, it's your misfortune and none of my own. Whoopee-tie-i-o, get along little doggies, you know that Wyoming will be your new home. fashion and none of my own. Whoopee-tie-i-o, get along, little doggies. You know that Wyoming will be your new home. I am sitting in front of it, but right behind me here, I have placed one of my paintings. And this is one I painted of Sedona, but it has that chaparral, sagebrush kind of look. Made me feel like it was an important part of the scenery. Will be new content, even though this is my last official live stream. There will be new content, and there is lots of stuff to see. And if you tap the bell so the notifications are on, then you'll get a little red one on your phone that tells you on YouTube there's something new and exciting, and you're gonna want to know. Looking mighty pale, was standing by the sheriff's side. And when that sheriff said, "I'm sending you to jail," Wildcat raised his head and cried, "Oh, give me land, lots of land under starry skies above. Don't fence me in, let me ride through wide open country that I love. Don't fence me in, let me be by myself in the evening breeze and listen to the murmur of the cottonwood trees. Send me off forever, but I ask you please, don't fence me in, just turn me loose. Let me straddle my old saddle underneath the western skies. On my cayuse, let me wander over yonder till I see the mountains rise. I want to ride to the ridge where the west commences and gaze at the moon till I lose my senses. I can't look at hobbles and I can't stand fences. Don't fence me in." Skies on my cayuse, let me wander over yonder till I see the mountains rise. I want to ride to the ridge where the west commences and gaze at the moon till I lose my senses. I can't look at hobbles and I can't stand fences. Don't fence me in, I'm the roving kind, so if you don't mind, all that I can say is, hey Trigger, let's be on our way. Who is this guy? This is, you might have noticed, it's not a horse and he's not a cow. I have a lot of stuffies and they're not horses and cows. So this is the only guy who would fit my spare cowboy hat. And it's a pretty rakish sort of situation, don't you think? Roy Rogers sang this more probably famously in 1944 in the movie Hollywood Canteen, where he is on his horse and talks to Trigger. So I had to have somebody to talk to there. One last little tidbit is, although it was one of his most popular songs, Cole Porter claimed it was the least favorite of his compositions. Okay, kids, so we're going to move up the time frame here, and we're going to go into the mid-70s for a song about cowboys, made famous by a duet between two famous, very famous country singers, and but written by Ed and Patsy Bruce. Maybe we don't know them. So if you get a chance to put in the comments who you think the famous duet is that I'm referring to. Okay, now I'm going to switch instruments here. Now, you didn't know that I could play the guitar, but I do. I do play the guitar, and I feel like we have to have a guitar for a country and a cowboy and the out on the range. So we're still out on the range, by the way, so do stay hydrated. It's a warm one, kids. All right, let me get my guitar picking fingers ready. And here we go. Make them be doctors and lawyers and such. Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. 'Cause they'll never stay home and they're always alone, even with someone they love. A cowboy ain't easy to love and he's harder to hold. And it means more to him to give you a song than silver or gold. But wiser buckles and soft-faded Levi's, and each night begins a new day. And if you can't understand him and he don't die young, he'll probably just ride away. Your babies grow up to be cowboys. Don't let them pick guitars and drive them old trucks. Make them be doctors and lawyers and such. Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. 'Cause they'll never stay home and they're always alone, even with someone they love. A cowboy loves smoky old pool rooms and clear mountain mornings. Little warm puppies and children and girls of the night. But them that don't know him don't like him, and them that do sometimes won't know how to take him. He's not wrong, he's just different, and his pride won't let him do things to make you think he's right. Mamas, don't let your babies grow up to be cowboys. 'Cause they'll never stay home, and they're always alone, even with someone they love. Okay, I hope you were singing along. And we do have a correct answer. And you probably can see that. There we go. That is the correct answer. Yep, absolutely. I hope I did it somewhat of a bit of a credit. And I mean, we couldn't be doing a modern song about cowboys without pickup trucks being mentioned there. So that was the... and puppies. So we got dogs and dogies. As you can see, I've done my hair specially for this, and the hat cannot come off. You know what it's like with a hat. Not gonna happen. Right, I have a very short little video. I haven't done anything super extra fancy today. I just wanted to do my farewell live stream with just a lot of singing along and good friends like yourselves. But I did do some short videos. They've become known as shorts, and they're typically a minute or less, and this one's right around that. During the pandemic, during the closing of regular things to do. So that was kind of fun, and I remembered I had done one that suits the bill. You'll recognize the hat. So here's a very short video to celebrate this theme. I hope you enjoyed that. I did several little shorts. They are all on my YouTube channel, like all my videos. Some of them are under the title shorts. Actually, YouTube does that. I didn't do that. Some of them were 1 minute and 6 seconds long, weren't considered shorts because of that sort of thing. It's hard to come up with something that's literally that short. Okay, while I have you just on this camera, I just want to say thanks to everybody. Obviously, I'm not done here yet today, but I don't want to forget that the whole reason I'm doing live streams is because of the lockdown and the lack of, well, for those who don't, that you don't know about the musical industry, with the pandemic, we were immediately out of work, all kinds of work, teaching, anything where you could see people. If you can remember back to 2020, you weren't allowed to see people, not right away, but pretty quickly, we realized that you had to come up with a way to make some money and stay involved in our career. And of course, for me as well, dealing with one of my large groups of people that I perform for, seniors, and I felt just so strongly that they needed to have their entertainment isolated at the best of times. And so anyhow, that's what it was. I'm teaching online, so have cameras and lighting and fun things. So yeah, some good things come out of bad things, and that is that I have learned new things. And there's lots of videos from these live streams on my YouTube channel. So yes, paintings, information on all my paintings. They're not for sale, but the prints and cards of them are for sale. There's 12 or, no, not 12. I forget how many. Had to keep busy. You have to stay healthy mentally, right?
Beat you if she's able. You know the queen of hearts.
chances. Come down from your fences. Open the gate. It may be raining, but there's a rainbow above you. You better let somebody love you. Let somebody love you. You better let somebody love you. Cowboys, of course, were also known as cowpokes, buckaroos, cowhands, and cowpunchers. The most experienced cowboy in the group was called Segundo, which is Spanish for second, and he rode squarely next to the trail boss. Of course, some cowboys went on to participate in rodeos. I don't know if you know, the first professional rodeo was held in Arizona in 1888. The cowboys that we know from TV and so forth in the States, the original cowboys that inspired them and they were derived from were called vaqueros from Mexico. And the Spanish word vaca is cow. Of course, there are other cowboys around the world. We've heard of the gauchos, and you may know that they are from Argentina, Uruguay, parts of Brazil, and the south of Chile. There's a great website called cowboyshowcase.com with all kinds of information that includes other countries like Honduras, Australia, and Canada that have current cowboys. Cowboys are still out there working. It's not like it's just from the 1800s here. And in fact, there's a ranch in BC in the Caribou region called the Gang Ranch. They were highly supported by the Canadian government in bringing up the cows from the States and making all the money. And I think a lot of times cows were as much value as gold to the economy. So what happened to the golden age of the cowboys? The decline was in the severest winter, which was 1886 to 1887. Temperatures plummeted and thousands of poor cattle perished. So scholars believe that was the end of the cowboy era. Of course, there's still cattle drives, but not like the movies that we see. Hollywood movies brought it back as a favorite sort of a theme. So why I'm doing it today, otherwise we might not have even thought of it. We're gonna think of film stars like John Wayne, Buck Jones, and as mentioned earlier, Gene Autry. You could also tune in to see fictional adventures of the Lone Ranger and Tonto, Will Kane in High Noon, and Hopalong Cassidy. There were comic books called The Black Rider and Kid Colt. Now, this is actually not a song. This is a medley I put together for a request that was a theme of cowboys, not country music. And I have performed this arrangement I made with my flute group last year called Fluterific. And so I just call it Western Medley. And it's gonna be a bunch of tunes here. See if you can catch them all. One of them will be familiar because you heard a little piece of it earlier. And I'm gonna be playing the string orchestra for this now. Here we go. Western Medley. up, move them on, move them on, head them up, rawhide. Move them on, head them up, move them out, move them on, head them up, rawhide. Cut them out, ride them in, let them out, cut them out, ride them in. Livestream was all about go west, which is something I have done myself, as a matter of fact. So, born in Saskatchewan, moved around the world somewhat like a cowgirl roaming the prairie looking for home. And I have been in BC many years. So, just like this. This is how I got to BC. My horse, what do you think? There is a cowgirl museum, the National Cowgirl Museum and Hall of Fame in Fort Worth, Texas, and cowgirl.net. Now, I did want to make sure I didn't miss the fact that there were some famous cowgirls. It wasn't really a career option. If a person ended up in that position as a female, a lot of times because their husband, let's say you're a ranch owner and your husband passed, you had very little choice but to take on the duties. There were very few choices. But of course, we can't forget to mention Phoebe Ann Moses. And you might be saying, who's Phoebe Ann Moses? Born in 1860. Growing up a poor family in Ohio, she learned to hunt and learned to shoot a gun, and of course became known by the stage name Annie Oakley. So I wanted to say, before I do my last song, that I saved this as a toast to everybody for being part of my live streams and helping me out and just being here and watching the videos. And for those of you that still support live music, my events are on my website. They're always under the news. So look under the news, the articles, the newer ones at the top, but they're all in there if you go down. So I hope you all have a little beverage here. I hope you all ride safely on the horse trail of life. Cheers. There was a cowgirl, and her real name was on my notes. And not Annie Oakley, but Frances Octavia Smith. Another name we don't necessarily recognize, but her stage name was Dale Evans. And she wrote the song here that's going to take us out. Thanks again, everybody. Some trails are happy ones, others are blue. It's the way you ride the trail that counts. Here's a happy one for you. Happy trails to you until we meet again. Happy trails to you. Keep keep smiling until then. Who cares about the clouds when we're together? Just sing a song and bring the sunny weather. Happy trails to you till we meet again. Big thanks to everybody for watching. And a big thanks to all the other musicians and other special guests that I had over the course of the many months. Jason with Cycle Driven Gardening had a special segment. He's been very busy and I'm very happy for him. So I hope you sing this with me. We're going to sing it one more time as we head down that dusty trail. Happy trails to you until we meet again. Happy trails to you. Keep smiling until then. Who cares about the clouds when we're together? Just sing a song and bring a sunny weather. Happy trails to you till we meet again. Till we meet again. Till we meet again. Thanks, everyone. That's all I have. It's been an emotional time. Reaching out with the music for everybody. I hope you take care. I want everyone to be happy and healthy. So on that note, and this one. And this one. Yeehaw! Take care, everyone. We will see you soon.